Hey folks, it's Erin, your hostess of It's 5 o'clock Here and cocktail editor for bourbonbanter.com. Now today I am here to talk to you about the most important meal of the day, nay the week, and that is brunch. Now at brunch, you're always faced with the conundrum of, do I go sweet or do I go savory? Do I choose eggs? Do I choose pancakes? Do I choose a Bloody Mary or do I choose a mimosa? Now the Bloody Mary, beautiful tomato, savory, a little bit of spice, as well as perhaps some heat. And then usually vodka, but you could also have gin, my favorite, or tequila, or even bourbon. And then in the other quarter, you have the mimosa, sparkling wine and a little bit of orange juice. Or you could sub out that OJ for a little creme de cassis and get a Cure Royale. Or perhaps you opt for some peach nectar and get a Bellini. But either way, the equation is the same. Sparkling wine plus juice or a fruit flavor. And those are your options. So today I have partnered with our friends from SAP 56 to bring you a third option, whiskey for breakfast. Now SAP 56 is named as such for sap, the maple sugar that comes out of the tree, you know, the little thing that you tap that siphon into the tree and that beautiful maple water comes out. And they collect that for 56 days during the maple harvesting season, take that water to the sugar shack where it is boiled down into that gorgeous amber, earthy flavored maple syrup we all know and love. They then take that grade A maple syrup and combine it with premium Canadian whiskey to get this really lovely flavored whiskey. And this is not like the normal flavored whiskey. This is not artificial flavors. You get whiskey and you get maple, and it's a beautiful combination. It's about 62 proof, so it's about 30% alcohol by volume. So, you know, it's not going to knock you over, but it is still going to give you that really lovely whiskey flavor as well as a little bit of that maple sweetness. So we are going to make the cocktail whiskey for breakfast. So you're going to start with your shaker tin and add in 1.5 ounces of SAP 56. Because, I mean, what screams breakfast more than maple syrup? I mean, you could just pour it on your pancakes, I guess, itself, but let's add a little bit more sophistication to it. And then because it's bourbon and banter, I'm from Kentucky, we're obviously gonna add a little bourbon. So I took 100 proof bourbon and I poured it in a jar and then I added brown butter. Brown butter, you just have to take a few tablespoons of unsalted butter, boil it down, well, I guess not boil it, but you have to melt it down and then let it keep cooking and crystallizing so those fats get nice and crunchy and dark and bring out this sort of nutty flavor. Then you take that melted butter, pour it into the glass jar. Glass is very important. It's much better for infusions. And you just shake it up with the bourbon, place it in the freezer overnight. The butter will solidify. You can skim it off the top. And then you're left with a fat washed bourbon with a little bit of that nuttiness as well as butter flavor. We're gonna do 1 ounce of the brown butter washed bourbon. Then we're going to add in 1/2 ounce of coffee liqueur because, I mean, let's be real, you can't have breakfast without coffee. I like this Mr. Black's cold brew. You could also use Kahlua. There's a lot of options for coffee liqueur. And then, you know, you can't have butter without a little bit of fruit. So I'm going to add some Bon Maman strawberry preserves. You could do raspberry, blackberry, actually apricot, or even orange marmalade would be beautiful with this as well. And we're going to do 1 tablespoon. Well, it doesn't sound nice. It's just plop, but it's very tasty. It adds a little sweetness as well as that fruit flavor. Then finally, we are going to add in 1 ounce of milk. I'm using 2% milk, but you could do whole milk. You could do whipping cream if you want to get a little decadent, 1/2 and 1/2, or you could use a milk substitute of your choice like oat milk or almond milk. We're going to do 1 ounce of our milk to make it extra creamy. And then my friends, this particular cocktail is a riff on a classic called the Flip because it's so flipping good. No, that's not why it's called that, but whatever. And what makes a flip is a whole egg. Don't be scared, it's perfect. Gaston ate like 3 dozen of these a day. Adding that egg makes it a protein shake. It essentially makes it a health food. I'm not a doctor, but you know, I mean, it tastes good and there's protein. It's delightful. And we're gonna pop this whole egg in there. I mean, obviously crack it, right? and just pop the whole thing in there. Swoosh. Now we're going to add in our ice. Make sure you add a bunch of ice in here. And we're going to give it a really vigorous shake for about 20 to 30 seconds because we really want to agitate those proteins in the egg. So go ahead and make sure it's nice and sealed and let's shake away. Let's see. Now we're going to open this up, and what we're going to do now is we're going to strain out our ice and do a little bit of a dry shake because we want to see if we can get just a little bit of foaminess on top, but there's already going to be a lot of fat in there from the egg yolk as well as the butter. Whoop! The butter as well as the milk. So we're not going to get a really frothy egg white like you would on, say, a whiskey sour, but that's okay. I have a plan. So you're going to go ahead and return this. Oh, it already looks delicious. Back into your shaker and give it another shake for about 15 to 20 seconds. Best part about a dry shake is I can hear myself think, ooh, this is gonna be really nice. Now we're going to serve this in a martini glass. I do stemless because I break everything. So once we have this all nice and shook up, I am going to now strain this into my glass. I mean, look at that color. Oh, I'm just gonna give that a little shaky shake. Oh yes, oh yes. And to top it all off, we're going to add a dollop of SAP 56 infused whipping cream. I just took some whipping cream, a tablespoon of powdered sugar to add a little touch of sweetness, and an ounce to an ounce and a half of SAP 56. Oh yes. Plop that right on top. Then we're going to do a little bit of a dusting of cinnamon and a fresh crack of nutmeg. Now, if you're a bacon person, you could always do a little bit of candied bacon or cooked bacon, just kind of drizzled over the top. And that, my friends, that's some whiskey for breakfast. Mmm. You could have that really any time of the day. I breathed in some cinnamon. So, SAP 56, part of this balanced breakfast, but obviously drink responsibly. Cheers, folks.